Hello and welcome to TAIK. I am mohammedadnant and in this video we are going to discuss about how to pass dynamic parameters in Power BI service. If you are new to this channel or if you haven't subscribed yet, just click on the subscribe button and also press the bell icon to get the latest notification. Now let's get started. This is the Power BI file and this, first of all, we need to create the parameters. I made a video about how you can create and manage the parameters. If you haven't seen that, just click on the link given on top of your screen. Even for this video also, I'll just quickly walk through the steps how you have to create the parameters. For that, first of all, you need to go to transform data. Click here. And it will open up the Power Query editor. So this is a table which I used the visuals on that Power BI file. So first of all, I'm going to create add as a new query. So right click here, add as a new query. I made a video about the add as a new query as well. So just check out the link given on top of your screen. So and then I'm running the duplicates here. So I got the list of the positions here. Now to create the parameter, go to home, manage parameters, and then new parameter. Here in this one, you have to assign, define a name. So in the type, I'm going to select this as a text. In suggested value, I'm going to use the query. In this query, I'm going to select the position which you have created here. And the current value, we have to define it here, default value. So I'm going to use it as accountant. So click OK. That's it. And then close and apply. Apply changes. So once it is done, you can publish this report to your Power BI service. I'm going to publish now. So this is done. Now let's go and have a look at the Power BI service. So this is my workspace and this is the report. Let's open this. Okay, now we have all the positions here and all the rest of the values are showing up here. Now there are some limitations are there, and let's have a look at the limitations. There are a couple of things to be aware of using this. The field type has to be string. The table and the field names cannot have any spaces. Table and field names are case sensitive. The values is not. Fields that are hidden from the report view can still be filtered. If the fields are hidden in the report view, that also included here as a filter option. The value has to be enclosed with single quote. So the field does not need to be present in the filter pane. It can be used any table or field within the model. So whatever the field which you are going to use here as a parameter, that should not be included in the page filter. So this is how you can able to define after the end of this URL of this report. So for example of this one, the report section, these are the numbers over there. After that, you have to apply these values. What does it contains is, the first is a question mark, and then the filter is a keyword equal to, and this the one is the table name. Table, and then the column of that table, and then space eq is a function, and then in single quote you have to define your parameters. So this is what it is. Now I will copy this. The filter match one is the table name, position is the column name, equal to software engineer. I will copy this here, and in the URL at the end of that I'll just paste it over there. Now this is how it will look like after this, and if I click enter, now it will show me only one value about the software engineer. In the parameter you can have the spaces, but for the table and column name there should not be any space. So if you look at this, it has filtered only the software engineer here. Now if you want to change the parameter, go again to here, and say for example software engineer instead of that software tester. Click enter. Yeah, it's turning to software tester. You might be wondering where is going to use this feature, right? If you have your own application in your organization, and you don't want to give access of all these positions to other departments, to other employees as well. In that case, you can just use the filter option of these query string parameters in your application, and you can just give the access to them. So for example, I've just used two here, software tester and software engineer. If the user has rights only to check the values of the software tester and software engineer, and they don't have the access of the accountant and team lead, these are the four open positions as of now. In that case, the user doesn't have access to view the information of the team lead and accountant. He has just access to tester and the engineer. So once he clicks on this link, it will directly go to this Power BI service with that parameter. It just opens up for the software tester. Now if you go back again here and click on software engineer, then it's open up only for the software engineer. Another example is if the employees are there and you have multiple locations, your offices are located on multiple different locations in the world, and some managers have access to the US region, some of them has access to the Asia region, and some of them have access to the Australia region. Say for example, if these three managers are looking at these three different regions and you have one single database, you can make just one report and use this parameter in your application so that whenever they click on this link based on the user ID, you can just pass the parameter in the Power BI service using this URL, and they can only see just US region data alone if he is taking care of the US, and he can just see only the Asia region if he is responsible for the Asia, and for the Australia region if he is responsible for Australia region. So there are multiple use cases out there, so this is just an example of it. Now the question comes is, can we pass the multiple parameters on that? For that also, there is a blog here. Yeah, you can pass the multiple parameters, but the thing is you have to combine the two of the columns. Here in this example, the territory and chain is the two parameters. For that, first of all, you have to create the calculated column with the inclusive of merging these two columns, territory and region, with just a hyphen to understand for the user. Once this is done, you can use the same thing here. There's a filter equal to the table name and then the column name with the territory and chain, the merge column, equal to this the parameter. So you can use the multiple parameters as well. So this is really a cool feature, how you can pass the dynamic parameters in the URL in the Power BI service to filter the reports. Thanks to the Adam Saxton to written this blog post on that. If you like this video, just click on the big thumbs up button. If you are new to this channel, or if you haven't subscribed yet, just click on the subscribe button and also press the bell icon to get the latest notifications. But make sure you turn on the notification on your devices. Share it with your friends and colleagues. If you have any queries and feedback, just post it on the comment section below. Thanks for watching. Keep learning. See you in the next video.